In this week's vlog, I'm still in Flanders, Belgium. I'm going to visit two badger sets where I have some amazing encounters with badgers. On a scouting mission right now, going to try and see if I can find that badger set. I got it as a tip from a friend, Frederik. He has a website, but I think he also has a YouTube channel. Finally, a badger track. I've been looking for these for a while, but since the ground is so rocky over here, lots of rock, so there are not many places where I can find tracks. So badgers are part of the weasel family, the stoat and the pine marten, beech marten and the otter. They're all part of the same family. And they all have 5 toes. I can count them over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And they have a large metacarpopet. That's what that line under the fingers, what we have also. And it's a bit kidney shaped with badgers. And on the front paw, the badgers have really long nails because that's their tool that they are digging with. Oh, really awesome. And if you like to learn more about tracks, I have an English language field guide on the tracks of West European animals. You can buy it from my website. I need to be quiet a little. I'll get you guys closer. So what I need to do now is take note which direction the wind is coming. I also need to figure out if that's the direction that the wind will be blowing tonight. And then I need to figure out how I can walk up to the badger set without them smelling me. And I need to find a place where I can sit. It really looks cool because I think there will be, if the sky is clear tonight, there will be lots of light. So if it's cloudy tonight, I might leave this for another night. Because it's quite a hike through the woods to get here. So it's also quite a hike back in the dark. Looks good. There's quite a bit of wind right now. I'll have to see what the weather report says for tonight, because often towards the evening the wind will settle. But right now the wind is coming from a really perfect direction, because if I would need to sit at the other side of the badger set, there's all bramble and nettle, so that would be really inconvenient. Not pleasant for myself, but also quite impossible to make photos. So I can sit at the good side of the set. There's not so much growth between me and the badger set. Yeah. And I'm a little bit above the set. That might not be the best location photography wise, but for a first evening, as I said, I don't even know for sure which entrances they are using, so walking uphill, walking, talking, vlogging. This vlog will resume once I'm on my way to the patch set. Wish me luck.
Unfortunately, the weather did change. It got cloudy and there was even a bit of rain. Before returning, I first went to another set, which is situated around a hollow road.
Patchy truck. So what am I actually doing over here? Well, this is another patchy location. I'm still in Flanders, at the Flemish speaking region of Belgium, which is closely related to my language, the Dutch language. And there's a patcher set over here. It's a hollow road. There's a field at the other side as well. Apparently they are feeding over there. So with some luck, I might be able to see feeding badgers and maybe badgers at their set. Patcher set is up there, but I think it will be really difficult to photograph the patches from here because there's so much nettle and bramble. That's really difficult. I will go to the corner of the fields and apparently that's a good place to see them coming from the set into the field whenever they're ready to start finding their food. So a good chance that they are already awake, so they might start feeding pretty soon.
Then I had to wait, a situation many wildlife photographers find themselves in quite regularly. It helps that it was a pretty landscape. I guess it looks a lot like the landscapes you might find in the UK. And although there was a bit of rain, it was nothing that would require me to change my plans. And while keeping an eye out on my settings as the light faded, I waited for the first badger to appear. After about half an hour, I saw my first badger. It looked like a young or a female badger by the looks of its face. It appeared much closer to me than I expected. I thought I was still a good 20 or so meters away from the set. Due to the long grass, I did not have a good chance to make a good photo, but the experience was awesome nonetheless. When the badger disappeared into the set again, I moved back to the hollow road. Here I was able to see some parts of the set which looked like they were in use a lot. And there the badger I saw earlier showed itself again, together with another badger. This time I was able to make a few photos, first of the single badger, but later also when they were grooming each other. And although it was quite dark, I really do like this last photo.
That was an awesome experience. First that female getting really close, that was great. Really awesome.
The next day I returned to the previously scouted badger set.
I'm on my way to the badger set. It's pretty cool. There's just a red kite passing over here, but I was too late grabbing the camera. Still quite early. It's 6:30 in the evening. Because I understood badgers can come out at this set quite early, like at 8 in the evening. Well, if that's going to happen tonight, I'm very, very happy. It's quite bright, there's still sun now and then, so it has the potential to become a very, very good evening of badger photography. And I like badgers, so. I'm also quite lucky with the wind. That's the valley, and then it goes up, and then over there is the badger shed, and the wind is going up, so I can sit above, a little bit above the badger shed, so I'm looking down, so that has an advantage with the wind. But also, yeah, the wind is going in that direction. Right after the badger shed, there's a lot of bramble and nettles. So if the wind would be the other way, it would actually not be good to sit at this badger shed. I only have one evening over here. That's always a bit of a thing, because usually, even though I scouted this badger shed, the more often I spend at a set, at a site, the better I will know it, the better I know what the wind will do. And also creatively, because this is still about photography, right? Creatively, I would increasingly know what to do and what kind of photos I can make, and where they would be walking, and if they would be walking there or there, what I can do with the background, or where I can be low on the ground. But so today is a bit about low-hanging fruit, and if I would have more evenings over here, more days, then I could try more difficult photos. Like gambling that I would use a certain trail, so I can use this or that tree. That's not what I'm going to do today. Okay, I'm nearing the set, so I'm going to turn off the vlogging camera right now. And fingers crossed they will show up. Wish me luck. I was still setting up the camera, and then I saw a badger walking. They just went out and they went down. I have no idea if they will return. I think I will just wait for a while over here. Gonna wait a while, see what happens.
Seeing badgers at 7 in the evening is really strange to me. In my area they always come out after the sun has set, and then also after it just gets too dark for photography. Now I was left hoping there would still be another badger in the set, or that the other badgers would return. But then, after about half an hour, I saw the top of another badger head appearing.
So he came out, then I could see him scratching and everything for a while already. Oh, and then he got out and walked in front of me. Yeah, not so far away we are. He dug a hole, a badger latrine. I got that on video, which is awesome because I can use that for my digital track and sign guide. So that is really awesome. And then he walked up towards me. I was really close. I had to zoom out. I think I got a few good shots.
When the badger walked straight towards me, I got the opportunity to make a few typical badger photos. I'm very happy with these, as I do not have such opportunities where I live. And although I got no hopes beforehand for some creative photos, I really liked the results I got. The motion blur while walking and the head partially hidden by the vegetation as he was searching for food resulted in a few photos, which are certainly not standard badger photos. I hope you liked this vlog. If you did, please do not forget to hit that like button. And please do subscribe if you haven't already. And then we will see each other again in my new vlog.